the Hong Kong government has launched a vast campaign to indoctrinate the next generation, and it is using history as a potentially powerful tool to inculcate obedience and patriotism among school children. When mass anti-government protests swept the Hong Kong city in 2019, the pro-Beijing officials blamed the education system for promoting liberal values and radicalizing Hong Kong. So now, they are aggressively promoting a specific narrative designed to reinforce the Chinese Communist Party's tightening rule over the former British colony. Primary school students in Hong Kong have to read picture books about Chinese traditions and learn about famous sites such as the Forbidden City in Beijing or the Great Wall. The central aim of the new curriculum guidelines, unveiled by the Hong Kong government this month, was much more ambitious: to use those historical stories to instill in the city's youngest residents a deep-rooted affinity for mainland China, and, with it, an unwavering loyalty to its leaders and their strong-arm tactics. The guidelines stated, students should develop a sense of belonging to the country, an affection for the Chinese people, a sense of national identity, as well as an awareness and a sense of responsibility for safeguarding national security. The Chinese government, in its efforts to quash dissent, has imposed a strict set of restrictions on Hong Kong, including new rules to bar any person deemed disloyal to the Communist Party from elected office. But the strategy goes well beyond repression. In some cases, the government has moved to literally rewrite history. It is backing the creation of a 66-volume set of Hong Kong Chronicles, which is projected to cost $100 million and promises a comprehensive, systematic, and objective record of the city's last 7,000 years. In official yearbooks that summarize the government's achievements, references to past cooperation with Western countries, which had been reprinted without change for decades, have disappeared. To the authorities, that narrative is a necessary corrective to ensure stability and unity. To the critics, it is social engineering, a misleading and dystopian campaign to shape young minds. The government's Education Bureau has denied that its new national security curriculum is brainwashing,